Hi. Okay, this is a great workout if you've got bad knees. So we're gonna lie on the floor. We're gonna be on the floor the whole time. You're gonna work your upper body, your abs, and your legs without leaving the floor. So get on the floor, get on your back, and grab your weights. Okay. So I'm gonna lie on my back. I'm gonna bend my knees, and I'm gonna lift my hips up. So we're gonna chest press here. You're gonna push up and pull wide. Down one, two, three. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Pulse them. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Push up again. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Pulse it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Push up again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Pulse it one more time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Put your weights down a minute. Okay. You can just keep your hands on the floor or you can put your hands behind your head. You're going to bring your legs up and you're just going to pull your belly in and rock your butt off a little bit. If you feel like you can do the upper body too, and you're just going to crunch right here. Otherwise, just pull the belly in and rock the legs just like this. Okay. We're going to do 30 seconds worth. So you're just gonna, let me change this. We're gonna do 30 seconds worth so that you can do at your own pace. Okay? Here we go. Like I said, you don't have to lift your upper body. Just focus on pulling your belly in and bring your tush up a little bit. It's not gonna go up far. Even if it comes up just even, you know, a teeny, 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 tiny bit, that's okay. We're working on strengthening the abdominals. Okay, we're gonna take the butt up again. We're gonna take the weights in our hands and you're gonna take chest flies. So you're gonna lift the hips up and you're gonna open the arms to the sides just like this, nice and wide, with very little bend in the elbow and back up. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five. Six, seven, eight, nine, 10. And we're going to pulse it. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Bring it back up. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, pulse, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Again, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, pulse, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Good. We do one more. Here we go. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, pulse. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10. Don't worry if that last set was too much because we did an extra one. Okay, you're going to bring your legs up again. Again, you're just going to pull your belly in and you're just going to rock. Even if it's, see, I'm not lifting my butt at all. I'm just bringing my weight, or bringing my legs forward because my abdominals are pulling in. That's what I want you to practice. Pull the belly in. If you can do the double crunch, great. If not, don't worry about it. Good. Okay, you're going to take one weight in your hand, just one of your weights in your hand, and you're going to straighten one leg, okay? So take one weight in two hands, you're going to hold the weight like this, so I have it so it's with the dumbbell heads in my hand. You're going to reach the weight with straight arms over your head, and then when you bring it up, you're going to lift this leg up and down, just like this. Okay? If you want it more advanced, you could lift your hips up here and do it like this. So I'll do it both ways just to show you. So I'll keep my hips down for this set. So we're going to take the arms over the head and we're going to lift everything. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. You're going to take the leg back and the arms back, and you're going to pulse. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Bring everything up again. Now, we're going to stay on the same leg. I'm going to lift my hips just so you can see the other way. One. Keep going with your hips down if you need to. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine, ten, and pulse. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Good. You're going to set the weight down, set the leg down. Remember what leg you just did, okay? You're going to take the leg up just like you did. You're going to place your hands behind your head. If you can lift your head up, great. You're just going to pulse right here. If you need to keep your head down, that's fine. Just pulse the leg here. So we're going to do it to time right here. You just want to pull your belly in. Think about pressing your back into the floor, okay? You want to pull the belly in, support the back, like drawing that belly in, pulling that belly button in. And rest. Okay, so we're going to do the other leg, and you can keep the butt down. Keep the arms straight. Let's start with everything up. And here we go. Reach the arms back. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10 and pulse. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Keep the butt down if you want. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Pulse. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Set your weight down. Again, you can always keep your head down. Straighten that leg out, and we're going to pulse. Just rest your head in your hands. Okay, now you're going to keep one weight in your hands. This time you're going to bend the elbows and straighten them. So you're going to go like this with your weight in your hands. Okay, bend and straighten. It goes right over your head and straight back up. Your hips are going to go with you. So you're going to do a bridge and lift up and down. Up and down. Up and down. If for whatever reason it's not working for you, just focus on the arms. If you can leave the hips up and do the arms, but you can't go up and down, then leave the hips up. That way you're working your butt, your glutes. Okay, ready? Here we go. Reach up. One, two, three. You don't have to go all the way back down to the floor. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. You're just going to pulse. Two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, one, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Pulse. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Good. Weight down. Hands behind your head. Okay? You're going to do oblique crunches, just marching. So what you do is you twist towards the knee that comes up and put the foot back down. Twist towards the knee that comes up. If for whatever reason you can't do the upper body and just the legs, that's fine. You can just do the legs. Now, instead of just going here, try to lift up and do this. March up in the air if you're just going to do the legs. Okay? Here we go. Twist towards the knee as it comes towards you. Okay, and then have you lift both your legs up in the air, and you're either going to lift or lower one down here, just tap the heel and alternate like this, and you want to reach the heel as far away from you as possible, or if you can do it, you're going to lower one leg down just as low as you can right here. It's a little bit straighter and you're not placing your foot on the floor. So you can start with bent knees and reach the heels out as far away from you as you can. We'll do that one first. So you're just gonna reach the heel as far away from you as you can. Stretch that leg out and reach the heel down. Again, working your abdominals. Good. Now if you can, you're going to lower one leg down and alternate. If that's too much, then just go back to reaching the heels like we just did. Reach the heels down. Otherwise, try and lower one leg just as low as you can. What will help you if you need help is hold on to the leg that's in the air. That will give you a little more support. So you would just switch arms and grab each leg. Okay? So you decide if you can do that. Good. Okay, we're going to sit up. You're going to grab one of your weight, or grab, yeah, one weight. Hold it right in front of you. You're going to lean back a little bit, and you're going to twist. Okay? If you get a little nauseous from, like, moving your head, don't move your head. Okay? So you're just going to twist. If you... You know, you don't have to move your whole body as much. You can kind of limit it here. See, I'm not moving my head now. And you just want to, lean back as much as you can. and twist into the waist. Okay, you're gonna lie on your side. Okay, so you want to take your legs so that they're kind of in front of you a little bit. So if I'm lying on this mat, I want to make sure my legs are at the front corner of the mat. I don't want them back here behind me or even what appears to be straight out. My body is now in proper alignment. If I go back here, I'm like, oh, I should be straight on the mat. Now my back is compromised. I'm not in alignment. So you want to come here. And you're going to roll kind of on your tush so you're not, you know, hurting your hip. So you're going to take the top leg and lift it up and down right here, getting into the waist. And I want you to take this arm and drive that elbow towards the leg. Now, if this is a little too, if you're more advanced and you want to lift both legs up like this, you can. But let's just start with one leg. I'll kind of show both. So we're going to do 30 seconds. So we'll do the first, just the top leg. And, you know, I really want you to dig that or drive that elbow towards the leg to bend. I'm cinching my waist like this when I come down. And I want you to bend this leg behind and flex this foot, and you lift this leg up here. If it gets too much in your shoulder, just lie flat and put your arm out flat. Try and remember about your, remind yourself about your abdominals. Just always think about pulling them in. Okay, we're gonna do that again. Remember, if you want, if you're a little more advanced, you know, now you can lift both legs up and down like this. I'll just focus on the one right here and driving that elbow towards the leg. Right here, lift up and down. Good, abs in tight, lift that leg up and down, flex that foot. Keep going. You should feel the burn in your inner thigh. It's a really difficult place to get to, so this is really great. This exercise, it isolates the muscles in the inner thigh. We're gonna switch sides. We're gonna do the same exact thing. So you can be up on your elbow here. If you need to lie down on here, you can do that too, and you would just go like this. Remember that your legs are slightly forward. They're towards the front corner of the mat rather than on, like straight out, what you think is straight out. And you're gonna take this leg up, flex this foot, and lift it up and down. Abs in nice and tight. I put 10 seconds in between. So we're doing 30 seconds, and then I put 10 seconds in case you need to rest. I just really never take it, but if you need to rest, you know that there's a second beep coming. Stack the legs in. Again, if you know, if you're more advanced, you can always lift your legs up like this. We're just working on some basics here. leg as high as you can. Don't be afraid, you know, that, or don't be concerned if you're not able to lift your leg very high. You'll get there. Again, drive the elbow towards the leg. This will be your 10 seconds of rest, so if you need it. So bend the knee, flex the foot, and lift it up and down. Abs should be in nice and tight. For the next exercise, if your knees are a little sensitive, you want to kneel on a pillow. Unless you've got a surface injury, you know, like you've fallen and bruised your knees, you should be able to be on your knees with a pillow supporting them, because we're not bending and straightening like you would in a squat or something. So put a pillow between your knees, pause it if you need to, and you're going to come onto all fours and come down your elbows, okay, just like this. And if it's a little, so this is really good alignment, but if you need to come up here, just watch to make sure your back isn't being compromised. I'm going to go on one elbow just so I can kind of look out, but you're going to take your leg back here and you're going to pump it up and down. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And let me pause and say that if you do need to do this off the knees, just stand, hold on to the wall or something. We're going to pulse the leg while I'm talking here. Pulse. 2, 3, and do this standing up. 7, 8, 9, 10. Back to the lift. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Pulse. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10, pulse, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Switch legs. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4. Try and flex that foot. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh God. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There is the biggest bug I've ever seen. I think it's a cricket though. 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Pulse. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Oh, gross. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Pulse. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I'm not sure what to do. I don't want to kill it. This is ridiculous. It's on the. I don't want to kill it. Because it's like, I think it's a cricket, and so I don't think it's going to hurt me, but I don't know what to do. Anyway, back to exercise. So, if you can stay on your knees, grab your weight. If it's bothering you, stand up. But try and stay right here. You're going to do a tricep kickback. So you're going to hold the weight here, and you're going to extend and bend the elbow. If you need to stand up, go ahead. Here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The show must go on. 7, 8, 9, 10. Switch arms. 1, 2. Just bend and straighten. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I thought I heard cricket noises the other morning down here. No, I think that's a cricket. 1, let's hope so. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Go ahead and put the weight aside, and you're going to walk your hands out for push-ups. If you need to come off the knees, go to the wall or go to something on an angle like a chair, and you're going to do 10 push-ups. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good. Push back. Push out your back. You're going to try and do 10 more. 1, 2, just do what you can. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And sit back. Good. Now I want you to take, if you're still okay, if you need to stand up, stand up. If you're still okay, I want you to take your leg out to the side. Okay, so now my leg is out to the side and it's straight. I'm just gonna lift it up and down. So it's out to the side. So if I turn here, okay, you can see my leg is out to the side. I'm going one. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. You can do this standing. 8 if you need to. 9, 10. Pulse. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Pulse. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Switch legs. Out to the side. 1, 2, 3, 4. Try and keep your foot flexed. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Pulse. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Pulse. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And sit back. Okay, now I want you to push back onto your feet and very slowly get up. If you're having trouble, crawl over to something, hold yourself up, stand up. You're gonna grab your weights one more time. I know my head is cut off, but I'm gonna bend over so it's okay. I'm gonna grab your weights and you're gonna bend at the waist and you're gonna row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Good, hold your weights here. You're just gonna bounce. 2, 3, 4, my legs are pretty straight. 5, 6, my heels are definitely digging into the floor. 8, 9, 10, row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Alternate arms if you need to. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Bounce. 2, sit back into your heels. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Rest a sec. Okay, now there's many more things you can do. You can do bicep curls, you can do more triceps, you know, you can do curls, you can stand and do a ton of exercises. But this is a workout that you can pretty much do mostly on the floor, abs, butt, arms, and we got all the major muscle groups. So when you're working your chest, your biceps are engaged, your triceps are engaged. When you're doing your push-ups, your biceps and triceps are engaged. So this is a bang for your buck workout. You're recruiting all of your muscle groups. So this is a really good way to increase your overall calorie burn by allowing your muscles to work very hard. They're gonna draw the water, they're gonna draw the energy into them, and you're gonna burn energy for a while, typically for about 24 hours afterwards. So this is a great workout to do if you're trying to tighten up, lose a little weight without hurting your knees. Thank you so much, and I hope that you have a really nice day. Love you guys.